national championship tournament. Ooh, this ref needs a new whistle. And welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the ACHA Division II National Championship Tournament, live from the Westchester Quad, Iceland Quad Rings here in Westchester, Pennsylvania. I'm Andrew Shapiro, alongside Brett Luthner. We're so excited to bring you this call today of Pool D action. Number one, Lindenwood Belleville Lynx, taking on the number four, Boston University Terriers. And we apologize for the late start, some technical difficulties, as there always are on day one, but we've got everything under control now. And we're happy to be with you as we see Boston University controlling the puck, sending it around for Teemer Hannon up the boards and out. Not Tyler Shubish, kept it at the line though by Ballerman. Thought that one cleared the zone. Curling with the puck along the boards is Alex Balbo. He's met by a couple of Lynx and a couple of Terriers come in to join him. 7:50 to go in this first period. We are scoreless. This is the second slate of games here on day one. All these teams obviously have 0-0 records. That shot blocked on the way in. Along the half boards it goes. Picked up now from the Lynx by Pagliacci. Pagliacci out in front. Save! Pagliacci scores! Nicholas Pagliacci danced out of the corner, took the shot, got his rebound and roofed it. And 2:31 in, Lindenwood Belleville strikes first.
And it's, Andrew, it's pressure. It's a hard-fought check. Lindenwood Belleville's got so much talent on this team. A hard-fought check to create the turnover down low and then capitalize on Boston not quite getting their complete coverage set up in the zone. And so Pagliacci, two shots at the second one roofed it. Here's the Lynx, a 1-0 lead.
There was a bit of a broken play there as that one sticked away by Jared Hines, the goalie for Boston University. Comes in today 3-4 with a 3.47 goals against, 8.95 save percentage, and a shutout to his name as that puck goes across the crease. Scooped up now by the Lynx in the person of, it looks like, Landon Hybert. Has puck knocked off his stick and away with it comes the Terriers. Michael Mnarchik sends down into the Lindenwood zone. Boston's offside, so Lindenwood will have a free out. It'll be scooped up by Derek Van Ness. Van Ness starts up, gains center ice. The stretch pass goes off the stick of Hybert and into the Boston zone. Lucas Esposito around the boards now. It's taken by his teammate Matt Feinberg. Takes a big hit right in front of us, and it's scooped back up by the Lynx. And across the way it goes and sent back. Two Lynx collide into each other, and Boston able to take over. Feinberg can't get anything going, and so Lindenwood will be able to start out. Hybert circles back, looking for an outlet. Finds it. This is Brad Edwards. Curls off a check along the right wing. He throws it in front of the slot. Bandit Janky shot, save. It's loose in front. And Hine never saw it as that one was thrown in front. And looked like Krusenberry had a shot at it, but the puck was just sitting in front. And it was a quick whistle by the referee. Our referees for today, Jim Anderson and Jeff Brody. Our linesmen are Steve Fries and Lee Giobi. As that puck goes into the corner, it's taken by Bruno. He takes a check for his efforts and sends up the wall. Out of the zone it goes. It's chipped forward by Boston. Into the skates of Krusenberry. Out of the zone it goes, intercepted by Bruno. Bruno throws it back and it's turned over. This is Mikhail Langmo. Dishes across. That pass from Janky got blocked. Back for Krusenberry. Off the boards it goes. Dished off now and taken by Dwayne Wainman. Wainman into the corner. He's got red jerseys on him. He turns it over. Both teams kind of finding their legs here, but
yeah, they are, you know. First trip to the national tournament for Lindenwood Belleville. Just the second year of their existence, and we know how dangerous of a team they are. Boston University, nobody thought that they would be here.
Boston University, the number 9 seed in the Northeast. They come into this tournament as a 4, and they almost have a chance there. It's kept in at the line by Scott Woods. He throws it into the corner. Belleville, the number 1 seed in the Central Region, and by many accounts, the odds-on favorite to win it all here in the tournament. But, of course, we have a lot of hockey left to go, and we're very excited to bring it to you here on YouTube. And we thank you all for joining in. That pass goes up and out of the zone, and so Lindenwood will have a free out taken by Adam Jacopin. He sends up and is taken back by Boston. Back and forth action, we have Brad Edwards with the puck. He sends a stretch pass just off the skate of Daniel Hussey. Hussey gets checked in on the boards but keeps possession. Gives it off now to his teammate, Wainman. Down low for Hussey. Hussey spins off a check but loses it in the process. And Lindenwood gets it back. Hussey shows it in front, blocked on the way, the puck bouncing around in the slot, nobody can get a handle on it. Hussey shot deflects into the corner off the skate of Benjamin Messick for Boston. Hussey gets his own rebound for the Lynx to the slot. Intercepted, taken back. And that puck knocked off the stick of William Varner and back to goes to center ice. Curling with it, this is Christian Tyson. Tyson drops it off for Wayman. Wayman into the slot. He shoots and a save by Hines. And I'm sorry, it was Tyler Weber who took the backhander as he went down. And some gathering in front of the net. It's no harm, no foul. 5:49 gone in the first period. It's a 1-0 lead for the Lynx.
Lindenwood comes in with a record of 28 wins and 4 losses on the season. So you know how dangerous they are.
And of those 4 losses, only one has come to a Division II opponent, that being Grand Valley State. There's a shot sticked away by Kyle Miller, the goaltender for the Lynx, and we'll get you the rest of the scores from earlier today as the game progresses. That pass goes down the wing for Weber. He shoots, looking on the back door for Hussey, but no luck. And Boston will turn it out to center. Holding Tyson. Across for Hussey. Hussey goes over the head of Jonathan Philly, but he gets it in anyway. Scooped up now by Ryan O'Lear. Up the boards it goes. Boston with an out. And away with it skates Michael Matos. He sends in deep and goes for a change. Miller will leave it. Sent around the boards and it'll be taken by Tyson. Tyson, a stretch pass, sticked ahead. Nice passing here. Oh, what speed there by Pagliacci. He walks in, he dekes it. I don't think Hines ever got a piece of it, but Pagliacci lost it. Over comes Boston, 3-on-2. Over center ice now. This is Hannon. He throws a shot, deflected into the corner. Behind that, looking for a teammate. Only finding white jerseys, however, as tangled up in the fray there is Matthew Feinberg, and a Lindenwood player will get you their number in a second. Looks like Zach Crawford. As Boston takes over their own zone, Alex Balbo turned over the puck, and it's coming back in with it now is Bishop for the Lynx. At center ice, the puck is sent back into the Lindenwood zone, and Miller has to come out and play it. He sends a stretch pass onto the stick of Landon Hybert. It's deflected into the Boston University zone, and Lindenwood offside, so Boston gets it out, and skating up with it now is Scott Woods. And we're going to stop the play. I think we're going to get our first penalty of the game here. And it's going to be a tripping call on Lindenwood Belleville. And that's Jared Bassard, the guilty party. So the first power play of the game belongs to the Terriers.
The time of the penalty will be 7:28. And so BU, and the thing with Boston University is Jared Hines, the goaltender, was stellar in the 3 games that Boston University played at regionals to get here to nationals. So it's going to require an excellent effort again on his part for Boston to have success here today.
And that's a good clear for Lindenwood. And you mentioned Hines. He comes in, I said it already, with a 3.47 goals against, 8.95 save percentage. He does have a shutout on the year. He's already lost that opportunity today, but he's hoping that he can backstop his team to an upset win there on day 1 as that puck trickles in on goal and Miller makes the save.
And Hines, keep this in mind with Hines is, in the regional tournament, he had a goals against average of 1. In the three games they played, I'm saying it was a little over 1. In those 3 games, so.
So a tall order here for the Lynx. They've struck early, and they're looking to pile on, but they're down a man as Boston University controls. This is a shot saved by Miller, and he'll cover up that shot off the point from Daniel Skoglund. And we'll talk about Kyle Miller. He comes in with a 12-2 record, a 1.84 goals against, save percentage of 939, and 3 clean sheets. So there's another solid goaltender there for Lindenwood, who are number 1 in the Central, as he gets a piece of that, and that goes up out of play off the stick of Nick Lupo.
It's a deep team. Lindenwood Belleville's got 5 guys, 6 guys that can really cause problems for your scoring. Hussey leads the group with 60 points. But, you know, you got other guys such as Brad Edwards, who's got 50 points, and a couple guys at 45, too.
So a lot of scoring all across the board as we get players going down behind the play, but skating around with it now is Adam Jacobin. Excuse me, that wasn't Jacobin. That was a shot saved by Miller. That was Skoglund who took it around in front, and we get some pushing and shoving, but cooler heads will prevail. And so with 1:13 to go on the penalty to Bassard and 11:45 to go in the first period, it's still 1-0 Lindenwood Belleville.
Yep, and the break went up on the board there.
So while Brett Futz is with the computer, we'll take it quickly around the league. Some earlier scores to report today. Miami losing to University of Utah 4-2. We'll get to the rest of them as it's 2-on-1 for Belleville. Edwards shot saved by Hines. And that puck hits the netting and trickles down behind the glass into the Zamboni area.
I'll give you those scores while I'm at it. Give me a second to catch yourself. Grand Valley beat Utah State 6-1 in Pool A. Will Patterson 6-1 over Lindenwood. The Lions here in Pool B on this rink. Pool C, Florida Gulf Coast, an 11-1 win over Keene State and Pool C action. And Pool B, Utah beat Miami 4-2. That's what this group is in as well.
Keene also making their first trip to the national tournament. Kind of an upstart team. They've been hovering around the middle of the ranks the last couple of years. They made it through regionals this year with an upset
over Northeastern.
Yep. So Keene, the upset over Northeastern, that was their ticket in. And Lindenwood Bobo, as we mentioned, the auto bet is the number one seed in the Northeast region. 37 seconds to go on the Bassard penalty and 11:07 to go in a 1-0 game as Lindenwood sends it the length of the ice. Boston really hasn't been able to do too much other than that one chance.
It's so tough because it's a talented team that Belleville's got. 13 Canadians and 2 Swedes on the roster.
Fazzo, a shot and a save there by Miller. That was John Fazzo taking the shot. Skating down the wing there, that is Lucas Esposito. He loses it back to Feinberg. Into the corner it goes. 10 seconds on the man advantage for Boston. Into the skates of Van Ness. They battle for a 3 aside. Van Ness all over his man Feinberg. 2 seconds and 1. There's the man advantage. So Boston 0-1 on the power play as that puck goes all the way down. And so we're back to 5-on-5 hockey, and Boston will attempt to start up with it. Pass ahead to Trubisch. Trubisch has the puck knocked off his stick by Wainman. Into the corner, Tyson. He knocks around Trubisch. Tyson sends it all the way down. Scooped up by number 10 for Boston versus Balbo. They battle for a 2-on-1. Balbo tries to get it back, loses it, and Trubisch will send it into the corner where it'll be chased down by Van Ness. Van Ness goes up the wall, and it's corralled at the center ice line by Tamer Hannon. Hannon takes a check for his efforts, and going back after him was Brandon Janke. At the center of the ice, turnover intercepted by Van Ness, and he sends into the corner. No icing on the player's hand in the first one there for Boston. He sends back around to his defensive partner, Alex Balbo. Up the wall it goes, taken by Shiler. Across for Trubisch down the left wing. Trubisch sends it lazily on goal, and it'll be sticked by Miller. And he sends a long pass. Kyle Miller can play the puck. Gloved down, however, by Schuller, and sent back up and taken now by Lindenwood. Here comes a shot and a save by Hines off the stick of Janke. And so with 9:19 to go in our first period, we are going to have our media timeout as we take a minute to thank all of our sponsors. And you are watching the ACHA Division II National Championship live from Westline in Westchester, Pennsylvania. We would like to thank GreatSkate.com, Sherwood, and Harrow Sports, the official apparel provider of the ACHA. And, of course, we'd also like to thank the Westchester Visitors Bureau, Iceline Quad Rinks, App Hanner, and our broadcast partner, Utah Hockey. We're very excited that Utah has partnered up with us for a second straight year, and we get a chance to bring you 27 games of ACHA Division II National Championship action, all for free, right here on YouTube.
Thus far, 1-0 Belleville, 9:19 to go in the first. And we're seeing both teams just trying to feel out how the other team likes to play, what they look to establish. Belleville, it looks like early on, they've loved that cross-ice pass coming out of the zone. Trying to spring the winger going down opposite side of the wall, you know, try to create a reversal of the ice, try to shift all the focus over to get the breakout going that way. It'll be interesting to see if they continue it or if they switch up their systems.
Absolutely, and you mentioned Belleville has a very diverse roster as we look at it together. Unfortunately, we can't really get a good camera angle on it, but we have a lot of foreigners, a lot of Canadians, a couple of Swedes, a couple of people from Minnesota, Pennsylvania, so one from Colorado.
13 Canadians, 2 Swedes, and then 5 more from Minnesota in terms of the state of hockey.
And so we'll get a face-off to the left of Jared Hines, and it's won by the Terriers. To the center of the slot it goes, and here comes Boston University skating up with it as Woods. Woods over the line and gets it into the corner where it'll be taken by Wingmo. Up the wall and out of the zone it goes, scooped up by Boston on a regroup. And Benjamin Messick has trouble with it. He pokes it away from the oncoming Wayman. It goes in front. Saved by Hines. Coming down the slot. It was a dangerous player by the name of William Varner. Into the corner it goes. Varner takes a stick for his efforts. No call. Circles around the half boards. Keeps possession of the puck as skating with it was Hussey. Into the corner it goes for Weber. Weber has the puck knocked off his stick. It sits there. And Weber finally skates out with it. Tyler Weber drops off for Hussey. Hussey makes a nifty move. Around the boards it goes, kept in by Langmo. Langmo holds the line and sends it on goal. That one saved by Hines. Kind of took a crazy bounce, although it might have changed speeds on the way as well. skating up with it for Boston University. That was Michael Minarchik, but away with it now comes Belleville. This is Hussey holding. Hussey drops back. A shot. Save for score! The puck was sitting in front. It looked like it was poked home by Varner. Wants to get the official scoring, but either way, Lindenwood Belleville goes up 2-0. 8:04 to go here in the second period.
It's in the first, you should say, but it's hard work in front, just clawing away at it. Sometimes, yeah, you might be a talented team, but you also just got to get the hard work done down low. That's what Belleville does, and right now the Lynx are off to the races.
If that goal does belong to Varner, it'll be his 16th of the season. As Lindenwood takes a stranglehold 2-0 lead, and on only the fifth shot on goal, too.
With Varner, his 16th goal of the season.
All right, so it is official. William Varner gets his 16th of the season, and Boston comes right back. That shot, I think Miller might have gotten a piece of it, as Boston is trying to mount a comeback. Out in front, shot saved by Miller. The puck is loose, and what a save by Miller as he cuts across. Oh, Kyle Miller! A blocker save on one post and a pad save on the other.
It's post to post, getting across, competing all the way through. Knowing that puck had popped over and he needed to make that save quickly, excellent job done by Miller there.
And I'm looking for a number 20 on Boston University, and I'm not finding one, so we're going to have to take a look at that.
That would be, we'll check it out.
So we'll get you whoever number 20 is on the score sheet. We'll get you that after the first period, as that pass is intercepted by Belleville in the form of Jonathan Philly. Back with it now comes Boston. This is Lupo. His shot glove save by Miller, and he'll hang on. So number 20 for Boston University is Jake Strzalkowski, playing in only his fifth game of the season. Boston is a very deep team with a lot of scratches, and Strzalkowski, one of those guys who's getting a chance here in Nationals against this top-ranked Belleville team.
And it's going to be a tall order for the Terriers in this one, for sure.
Well, you never know. We love courting the NHL here, and I love bringing up the example of Chris Kreider, who got a chance because Carl Hagelin was suspended. And look at him now. Back to the here and now, though. Boston down 2-0 and trying to make something happen. That shot, another blocker saved by Miller off the stick of Taylor Parkinson. Out to center ice and chipped back into the Boston zone. Down to the ice went to Mann and Feinberg. No call. And it's down the left wing. Walking in with this is Bishop. His shot goes wide. Behind the net, they battle for it. Stuck on the back of the net, but finally it comes free and away with it. Skates Boston. That's Lucas Esposito. He sends up to Feinberg. Feinberg against his opposite number four, Derek Van Ness, who has the puck. Van Ness with some speed. Hops over the stick of his intended target, Tanner Duffney. And Boston will have it now with 6:25 to go in the first period. 2-0 lead for the Lindenwood Belleville Lynx. Skating up the left wing, this is Messick. Messick's got a 3-on-2. His pass looking for Parkinson. Instead, he finds Esposito. Shot never made it through as it was a pass back for Parkinson.
I think Beer tried to do too much there.
Can't do too much, especially down two. That shot catches the high glass off the stick of Brad Edwards. Along the Zamboni door, they fight for it. The puck comes free along the stick of the white jerseys, and this is Krusenberry. Down low for Wainman. Back down low. Back to Wainman. Pass intercepted by Boston. Skating up with this is the captain, Dylan Schuller. Schuller sends in deep and takes a check for his efforts and goes right back to Krusenberry. Some good hard-fought action as now Schuller goes after Krusenberry again. All perfectly legal, of course. That puck played on a high stick, and it's into the corner. And Boston never touched it, but the whistle is blown for intent to touch, and so we'll get a face-off. I believe it will go all the way down, and so... No, they're going to rule that it goes...
I'm sorry, no,
it should come all the way down, but they're going to rule the face-off will stay at center ice.
That one zone, either way. Well, 3-on-2, Boston, I think, again, try to do too much, try to make too many passes, try to make it look too good to get back into the game, and so you got to just keep it simple.
Absolutely.
Keep it simple.
Absolutely. The name of the game here is keep it simple, as that puck goes way up, almost hits the rafters, but doesn't, and so Boston will start up with it. A nice move made there by Fosso. Fosso shoots blocker, saved by Miller. Fosso into the corner, throws it in front, hits a Belleville stick, but catches a friendly bounce and away with it skates Wainman. He sends out of the zone and Fosso will take over for Boston. Fosso looking for a man. He finds Minarchik. He sends it off the boards and it's taken by Belleville. 5 minutes exactly remain here in this first period, and it's 2-0 Lindenwood with Belleville. If you're just joining us late, goals by Lucas Pagliacci. And as of right now, it's William Varner. And right now it's William Varner. And this is Brandon Janke throwing in front, and Hines will cover up. And we'll get a whistle with 4:42 to go in the first period.
And we're seeing, 12-8 of the shots, and Boston University is able to get some opportunities against Lindenwood. I think, we're seeing this is they're adept on offense of the lengths. Just see if they can have opportunities against them at the other end.
And a couple of big saves by Kyle Miller, too. He absolutely robbed Strzalkowski on the back door there. And so Belleville will try to start up. That pass hits Gates on the back end, and here comes Strzalkowski down the left wing. Strzalkowski takes a check but keeps the puck. Holds and sends it to the point. Shot by Hannon, deflected, score! Deflected in front by Nick Lupo! And Boston's on the board with 4:16 to go in the first.
Well, and that's the thing is Lindenwood, Lindenwood Belleville. Now, the one problem there is they kind of got away a little bit covering in front of the net. Weren't able to cover that well. Let traffic set up in front, which allowed that screen opportunity to happen. So for Belleville, they can score goals. But now let's get into the corner, as I said a moment ago.
So Lupo gets the goal. That is his second of the season with the assist to Hannon and Strzalkowski. As Belleville tries to come back the other way. So now we got a hockey game. It's 2-1 with 3:55 to go. And Van Ness will take over for the Lynx. He sends it into the stick of Tyson. Tyson gains center ice and sends it into the zone. Rolls just wide. Hines gets a stick on it and tries to leave it for his teammate, Scott Woods. He takes a check from the oncoming Daniel Hussey. Stretch pass intercepted. Shot blocked on the way. The shot was taken by Pagliacci and blocked by Woods. Down the right wing. There's a shot and a blocker save off the stick of Parkinson. And a long stretch pass goes into the glove of Ryan O'Leary. O'Leary goes back to the point for Woods. Sticked into the zone by Feinberg, who was dying and lost an edge, but poked it in behind the goal line, and it'll be taken over by Langmo. Langmo takes the stick, but starts up anyway. Sends out to the wing. And Lindenwood is offsides as down to the ice hard went Jonathan Philly. And so the whistle will bring an offsides face-off just outside the Boston zone. 3:07 to go in the first period. It's a 2-1 lead for Lindenwood Belleville.
And good response coming off the goal by Belleville, to just keep with it, keep the intensity level up. And you have to like to see that when you give up a goal, you want to see how the team bounces back. And sometimes teams, when they get that goal, all of a sudden they sag a little bit. It's like, next thing you know, other opportunities to make themselves available.
And you got to give your hats off to Boston University. They knew what they were up against, and they've played, they've shown nothing but heart and hustle here in this opening 17 minutes and change. Cram job along the wall, and it's taken over by Boston. As Brett laughs, it's a little bit of an inside joke for those laughing at home. Puck is sent all the way down, and it'll be scooped up by O'Leary. O'Leary, a cross-ice pass. Chipped into the zone off the stick of Schuler. Behind the net, it goes for Van Ness. Van Ness breaks out slowly. That one is tipped and goes into the boards by Riley Murata as we get a whistle. 2:22 to go in the first period. So the faceoff will be just outside the Lindenwood zone now. Here's some good encouragement coming from the Boston University bench. They're only down a goal against this very tough Lindenwood team, and you really hear how they're responding, given their effort. Into the corner, this is Landon Hybert. Takes it back, throws it in front, backhander. What a save by Hines, the puck is loose! And Bishop couldn't bury it. Jared Hines sliding across and got the glove out to knock it out of the air.
He was caught a little bit out of position and competed. He fought for that one.
He saved it well, though. Along the boards it comes now. Boston can't break out. It's kept in by Tyson. He sends behind the net. Bishop with it. He throws it out in front. Looking for a man. That's Bassard. Puck is knocked off his stick. This is Bruneau. Brady Bruneau behind the net. He's coming up the left wing now. And sent in was Mrazek. Tyson behind the net. Puck is intercepted by Gates. Along the boards it comes, Janky. Stolen away, this is Gates down the left wing. He holds, he shoots, and that one catches the high glass and caroms all the way around. Puck chipped out of the zone by Wainman all the way down. The race is on, and it's won by Brad Edwards of Lindenwood Belleville. Off the side of the net and goes onto the stick of Strzalkowski. Strzalkowski up the wing. He sends ahead. This is Gates along now for his teammate, Lupo. Away with it now comes Belleville. It's sent into the corner. Under a minute to play here in this first period. It's a 2-1 lead for the Lynx. As taking over is Messick for Boston. Puck is kept in at the line. And kept it again, but just barely, by Janky. In the corner now, spinning off a check is Wainman. This is Gates now. Michael Gates sends a cross-ice pass. Miller comes out of the net to play it around for his teammate, Jacopin. Comes back across the ice. Sent into the corner. And across it goes for Jacopin. He sends a cross for Bowerman. Bowerman will start up with 13 seconds to go in the period. Stretch pass goes over the head of the racing Weber, and it'll be an icing with 7.9 to go in the first. So we'll have an offensive zone faceoff to the right of Kyle Miller. And after the first period, Brett Luthner will have an interview, hopefully with one of the coaches, and looks like they're going to call offsides as opposed to an icing. So the faceoff will be just outside the Belleville zone. Shots are 14-9 in favor of Boston here in this first period. Face off won by the Lynx, sent across. Holding this is Tyson. Excuse me, that wasn't Tyson, that was Jacopin. All the way down, and there's the horn for the first period. So at the end of the first period of play, it is the Boston University Terriers trailing 2-1, but leading in shots 14-9. And as we wait for Brett Luthner to get an interview, he looks like he's heading over to the Boston University bench, and he will have Coach Greg Carr standing by. Or will he? Keeps backing up. All right, so we're going to go ice level now to Brett Luthner with Greg Carr.
All right, Coach, end of one, down 2-1. What do you think about your team's performance there in the first?
I think we came out a little slow for us, and I think the nerves got to him a little bit, and we got better as the period went on, and we hope to improve in the second.
That deflection goal really seemed to spark a fire under your team there. Talk about that.
It did. You know, I just told our guys to get some shots on net, get it down the other end, and you never know what's going to happen. So for them to get a goal here, it gives them a little bit of confidence, and that's all you need. And once our guys get confidence here, they can do anything. So that's what we're looking for the rest of the way.
All right, good luck in a sec.
All right, thank you very much.
All right, back to you, Joe.
Thank you, Brett. That was Greg Carr at the end of the first period. It's a 2-1 lead for the Lindenwood Belleville Lynx. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back with second period action, and you are watching the 2016 ACHA Division II National Championships from Iceline Quadrinks.
Check one, two.
Pennsylvania for day one of Pool D action. We have the Boston University Terriers and the Lindenwood Belleville Lynx. Lindenwood leading 2-1. I'm Andrew Shapiro, joined alongside Brett Luthner. We're so glad that you were able to join us on this afternoon. We thank you for watching the ACHA Division II National Championships on YouTube. And for those people that are here, we thank you as well. Scoring summary after the first period. Nicholas Pagliacci scored first for Lindenwood Belleville at the 2.5 minute mark, putting the Lynx up by one. William Varney added his 16th of the season, make it 2-0, and Boston struck at the 15:44 mark of this first period. Nick Lupo deflected a shot from the point, and that's where we stand. So we'll have Boston in the red jerseys trimmed with white moving left to right on your screen. Belleville in the white jerseys trimmed with black moving right to left on your screen. As the puck is corralled by Kyle Miller, he leaves it for Christian Tyson. To the boards, it's kept in and hops over the stick of Messick, and it's stolen away. Working across was Janky. He thought he had a man, but it's stolen away. This is Janky one-on-one. He walks in, passes across. That one looking for the stick of Edwards, but couldn't tap it home. Edwards stick handling along the blue line, sends it across the ice, and it'll be intercepted by Benjamin Messick. Intercepted again. Edwards to the point. Finds the glove of Wayman. He was looking for the stick, and it hops out of the zone. Van Ness. Quick turnover. Lupo gives it back, right back to Edwards, and it's sent in behind the net. Big check along the boards as down to the ice hard went Benjamin Messick. Wayman sends in, intercepted by Boston. Skating up with this is Woods. Scott Woods, one on two. He shoots, and that one lazily goes into the corner. Wayman goes into the boards hard against his opposite 17, Michael Gates. Behind the net now, this is Tyson. Tyson has a lane and takes it. Long outlet pass off the stick of Daniel Hussey into the glove of Jared Hines, and we'll get a whistle with a minute 16 gone in the second period.
And so far, both teams again coming out and not real, can't really get too much going in their attack. And so I have a funny feeling we're going to be set up for something really good here in terms of how these teams go about this game. This might not be the blowout that some might have expected early on.
This is a 1-4 matchup here in Pool D. The earlier game in Pool D was a 2-3 affair between number 2, University of Utah, and number 3, Miami of Ohio, with Utah winning that game 4-2. As of right now, we have the puck with Daniel Hussey in front. Backhand saved by Hines and blocked away off the stick of Wayman.
Other scores, last check, Liberty and Arizona State Maroon were scoreless in the first period. NYU had a 2-1 lead in their game. That was in the first period as well, that over Utah State. And the last one, it was over Penn State, I should say, and Liberty had a 3-1 lead over...
No, as Arizona State has a 3-1 lead over Michigan State at the end of the first.
Sorry about that.
So we had 2-3 matchups this afternoon, and 1-4 now in the second slate of games at 3 and 3:15. Right now we've got a tie-up along the wall, two aside. A colossal amount of players, and away with it, this is Balabal across the ice. Shot never made it through. That one went off the stick of Hannon. That was shot deflected and blocked on the way. Marota tries to send in deflection, saved by Miller, and another save by Miller off the rebound. He robs Turbish.
Now he's doing a good job of tracking through your screen. There's a lot of traffic in front of him, Andrew, and he's doing a good job, Miller is.
That pass goes out in front, but off the stick of William Varner. Puck sitting at the bottom of the circle. It's stolen away by Belleville. This is Hussey. Shot! Score! Might have been tipped in front by Varner. If that's the case, that's his second of the game.
That was a one-timer in the slot. Just set up there. The bullet in the slot. And it's the one thing that Belleville is doing really well is what they're doing is they're finding those open spaces behind the Boston defense. And when you find those open spaces, eventually... the pass is going to find its way to you. Lindenwood does a good job of just finding open ice, and that's a credit to their coaching and how they've gone about business thus far. So important third goal there for Belleville.
And once again, Lindenwood Belleville scores about 2.5 minutes into the period. They like this early and often.
Yeah.
Boston will try to mount a comeback, but that won't help as this is Jonathan Philly down the left wing. He makes the move, and offsides by a mile was...
That was
That was
Brady Bruno.
That was rather offsides.
Yeah. Offsides by a mile, and so we'll get line changes on both sides. It's a 3-1 lead here for the Lindenwood Belleville Lynx. 17:04 to go in the second period. Shots are 15-12 in favor of Boston. Face-off is won by the Terriers. Strzalkowski knocks the puck back. And it's sent into neutral ice, and it'll be picked up by Bruno. Bruno gets sticked by Strzalkowski, but leaves it for his partner, Dylan Bellerman. The race is on. This is Janky. No, sorry, that's not Janky. That's Nicholas Pagliacci. All over a Boston player who skates up with it in the person of John Faso. Has the puck knocked off his stick, and Strzalkowski sends him behind the net. Miller will stop it and leave it for Bellerman. Bellerman across for his partner, Jacopin. Puck intercepted. Jacobin had it in his feet, and it's off the glass and kept in by Faso. That shot deflected on a high stick by Gates, and it'll be played by Belleville, so play on. On a second effort, it goes back into the Boston zone, and Woods will spoon away. Scott Woods starts up the left wing. He stops. He's checked by his opposite 22, Landon Hybert. Goes back for Strzalkowski. Spinning away with this now is Jake Strzalkowski. Intercepted at the blue line. And back into the neutral ice it goes. Bellerman sends a pass. On to the stick of Hybert. But he has it knocked off his stick, and it's sent around by Woods. Tyson keeps it in for Lindenwood. And it's kept in the feet of Kyle Bishop, and out it goes on a second effort. This is Bishop. He takes a hit from O'Lear, but... And we're going to get a penalty as O'Lear is going to get 2 minutes for interference as he got in the way of Bishop trying to get to the loose puck. So Belleville will have their first power play of the game with 15:33 to go in the first period and a 3-1 lead.
It is a dangerous power play, Andrew. Belleville can score lots of goals, and when you give a team with talent a man advantage, it makes it that much more lethal. And so Belleville with an opportunity to really put a little distance between themselves and Boston here in the second period.
A crucial moment in this game early on in the second period, as if Boston can kill this off, it's a big momentum swing for them. If Belleville can score, it just increases the distance, like you said. But Van Ness walks the line. He throws a shot deflected and into the netting out of play off the stick of Tyler Weber. So a very quick whistle, just 7 seconds have gone by in the penalty.
Yeah, it's one thing I noticed about Lindenwood Belleville, they do a good job of, it almost looked like they started out in a neutral zone trap, and then as the puck kept on getting deeper and deeper into the Boston zone, they brought the pressure higher and higher up. It's a very interesting, almost like a hybrid way of thinking about things. And it was very, at least in the last few minutes, I've been noticing it. And so let me see if that continues during the course of this game.
Some confusion about where the face-off would be, but instead it's a face-off in the Boston zone, and it's sent all the way down. Miller loses his edge and takes a spill in the corner, but leaves it for his teammate Tyson. Tyson a stretch pass down the right wing. Hussey can't get the puck into the Boston zone, and Tyson will have to regroup and start over for the Lynx. 30 seconds have gone by in the power play, and 15 minutes remain in the second period. Into the corner it goes. Marotta there against Van Ness. Puck sent up the wall, and it'll be taken by Weber. Down the left wing he comes with speed. Chipped in behind the net. First one there is Faso. Faso up the wall and kept in by Tyson. He fakes a shot, spins, and sends it down low. Back to the point it goes. Tyson keeps it in. And a possible 2-on-1 here for Boston. Skating up with this is John Faso. Down the wing. He shoots, and a glove save by Miller. He plays it out for Tyson. Miller leaves it himself and sends a long stretch pass. Hops over the stick of Weber all the way down, and this will be an icing.
And Miller wanted to hit that long pass, try to catch Boston maybe in a little bit of a change to the front end here, but just missed the mark. It took one hop and sent all the way down. So face off to the right of Miller, and we'll see what happens in this draw.
Kyle Miller loves to play the puck, and we're seeing it more and more in this game. 53 seconds to go in the man advantage for the Lynx, and 14:23 remain in the second period that sees them with a 3-1 lead. Weber holds, drops a pass off, shot blocker saved by Hines. That one off the stick of William Varner looking for the hat trick. Woods with it for the Terriers. Up the boards and cleared the length of the ice. Goes on goal, so Miller will get a chance to play it. Instead, he just leaves it behind the net for Hybert. taken instead now by Brad Edwards. Edwards with a head of steam and 22 seconds to go on the power play. Cross ice goes on to the stick of Hybert. Hybert makes a move. He shoots, and it never made it through as it hit a red jersey on the way in and cleared the length of the ice by Michael Matos. 10 seconds remain on the man advantage, and 13:40 go here in the second period. Last rush possibly here for the Lynx with the man advantage, and turning back with this is Mikhail Langmo. Back to full strength are the Terriers, and so Lindenwood is 0-for-1. That puck caroms off the boards and has to be covered up by Hines, and we'll get a whistle with 13:27 to go in the first period.
Or in the second.
Second period. Excuse me, yes.
Don't scare me for a second. I tell you what's happening right now is Lindenwood trying that stretch because they want to catch Boss, you know, maybe a couple guys going off, maybe a couple guys getting a little too aggressive on the forecheck. But Lindenwood's trying to stretch the ice out a little bit. You know, if anything, maybe they hit the home run or just set it up and get their breakout a little bit easier. But another thing to keep an eye on.
So they're going to rule that was an icing on Lindenwood, and so they'll have to start over again. And it'll be taken now by Edwards. Comes up the center of the ice. He goes into the corner. Takes a check, but goes after the puck. Intercepted by Boston. And it hops over the stick of Esposito and onto the stick of Hybert. Gloved down by Feinberg. Edwards with it now. Loses the puck. Skating in with this is Esposito. He drops it back. Feinberg walks in. He shoots a pad save by Miller. Behind the net it goes. Out in front. Spinning a shot. Never made it through. That one's a pad save by Miller. And another pad save by Miller. Twice he stops Parkinson. The battle for it to his side. Jacopin going in there against Esposito. The puck comes free and it'll be taken by Belleville. Cross ice pass finds Edwards in the center of the ice. Edwards tries to throw it on goal. It sticks wide. And he rides man hard into the boards. That was Belleville. All the way down it goes. No icing. It was played off a Lindenwood stick. Miller has to come out to play it. He sends an outlet pass onto the stick of Skoglund. Skoglund finds a man. This is Edwards. Partial break. He tries to throw it in front, but good back checking by Fosso interrupted that play. Edwards has it looking back door, but can't find anybody. It's intercepted by Boston. Good back checking play there by Langmo to keep that puck in the zone momentarily. Long pass on sides and not too many men. Pagliacci drops it back to his back. Saved by Miller, by Hines, excuse me, and the puck is loose. Shot. That one goes up and over the net. Cam's back shot. Another save by Hines. And the puck is whistled down. Boy, you don't get much easier than that. Nicholas Pagliacci looking for his second of the game. Shot it high, and we remain 3-1.
Yeah, it's, and again, this is a situation that, that one took a real hard hop off the glass behind. And Hines had to flop around a little bit, making a couple of those saves.
And he makes another save there, kind of difficult. He gloved it away using his opposite hand. And starting up with this now is Lupo, who has the goal for Boston. He sends a pass onto the stick of Woods. Woods gives it back to Lupo. Out in front, looking for his teammate, Gates. To the point it goes. Messick throws it across for Woods. He sends around low for Gates. Sharkowski there for Boston. Goes to the point. Woods keeps it in. 11:20 to go in the second. Shot by Lupo. Caroms wide, and the puck carries off the glass. Kept in by Messick into the Zamboni corner. Woods takes a man down. We're going to get a penalty. Excuse me, that was Gates. And so we get a stoppage of play, and it's going to be a power play for the Lynx with 11:05 to go in the second period and a 3-1 lead.
Yeah, this is now you're getting into the realm of playing with fire. You don't want to continue to give a team with talent as Lindenwood Belleville the opportunities on the power play. And so, you know, along the boards there, a little bit of extra penalty call, and now Boston again has got to survive this power play.
Michael Gates, 2 minutes for tripping, and Belvo goes back on the power play. They are 0-for-1. Wayman sends down low and tries to get it back, but instead it's left for Hybert. Hybert along the half ball, sends down low to Wayman. To the point it goes for Langmo. Back for Wayman. Top of the circle, he sends down low to Hybert. To the point it goes for Langmo. His shot, score! Mikhail Langmo beats Hines in the top shelf. It's a power play goal for Lindenwood. And it's 4-1 with 4 to go.
Yeah, it's just, again, when you play with fire, sometimes that one just worked its way back out to point. Lingo, with traffic set up in front, take that through, and this is where you start to wonder if Belleville's going to do a pull away here, now up 3 goals.
That power play goal, huge for the Lynx, and for Mikhail Lingmo, that is his 11th goal of the season. Puts the Lynx up 4-1 with 10:35 to go in the second period. Puck sent around, and pinching in, it goes into the feet of Riley Marotta. Around the net it goes, it's taken by Van Ness, up and past the outstretched arm of Messick, all the way down, the race is on. No icing as Wood fetches before the puck went over the line. Tries to check his man, and harsh words being exchanged, but nothing called as the puck is sent back around the net. Miller there holds it, sends up the wall for Tanner Duffney. He takes a check for his efforts and loses his stick in the process. Still going after the puck, though, is Duffney, and Tyson tries to clear it out for the Lynx. It's cleared on a second effort all the way down, and Woods wins the battle. And so we'll get a stoppage of play and a face-off to the left of Kyle Miller with 9:52 to go. And since there is an icing, Belleville cannot change, and so we will not be taking our media timeout.
Not yet.
Not yet, anyway.
We might be soon. But,
so it'll be a face-off to the right of Kyle Miller. And it's won by the Terriers. That shot glove saved by Miller, and he'll hang on. And so now we should be able to take our media timeout. I remind you that you are watching the ACHA Division II National Championships live from the Ice Line Quad Rinks in Westchester, Pennsylvania. We'd like to thank Gong Show Hockey, Warrior, and Howie's Hockey Tape, the official tape provider of the ACHA. And we'd also like to thank the Westchester Visitors Bureau, Ice Line Quad Rinks, App Hammer, and our broadcast partner, Utah Hockey, who we're very grateful has been able to bring us this broadcast free of charge for the second year in a row. So we're at our media timeout. There's 10:09 gone by in the second period. It's a 4-1 lead for the Belleville Lynx. Brett, what have you seen so far?
Belleville, eventually, they're starting to, again, when that puck gets deep in the zone, they're applying the pressure. They're hard on the puck, which is causing a lot of stress for Boston University. Create the turnover, counterattack goal, power play goal there earlier. That's pretty much what they do, is they pressure you into making mistakes.
They're a high-octane team, they're firing at all cylinders, and they're dangerous with a lead, which they have now. That puck sent all the way down and hops over the stick of Hannon. No icing as the referees rule that Hannon had a shot at it. Hannon starts up with it now. It's a 3-on-2 for the Terriers. Tie it. Taylor Hannon. His shot glove saved by Miller, and he'll hang on.
And almost, the one thing I do notice, though, is sometimes they get caught, and Boston has the opportunity to escape the other way. 18-16 shots in favor of Boston right now in this game, which you wouldn't think, when you see 4-1, but it's the way Lindemann plays.
And also shows that Lindemann has been able to capitalize on all of their opportunities. And they have one here, skating up with this is Dylan Bowerman. Bowerman into the corner. He drops it off for Hybert. Excuse me, that wasn't Hybert, that was William Varner. Varner has it back, and it's covered up by Hines, and we'll get a whistle, and
the clock never moved.
The clock never started, apparently.
Clock never started.
So, officially there are 9 minutes and 28 seconds to go.
And nobody was noticed
in the second period.
Yeah, everybody's going to get an extra 20 seconds of play out of this whole deal.
All right. To the point it goes. Bowerman fires a shot. That goes wide. The rebound. Hines covers up. This goes across the net. He scores! It remains to be seen who's going to get credit for this goal. But that goal will stand. And so with 9:22 to go in the second period, it's a 5-1 lead now for the Lindenwood Belleville Lynx.
Plugging away in front. Just plugging away. Couldn't see who got the final touch on to put it home, but they just keep on getting at it. And sure enough, at some point, popped in the net.
Could have been Daniel Hussey, it could have been William Varner, it could have been anybody else. So we'll wait for the announcement and figure out who scored. In the meantime, Belleville has the puck again. The pass goes onto the stick. Oh, Varner, he shoots! Score! No! No goal. They're going to wave it off as Dwayne Wainman had a breakaway, put the puck in, but they're going to rule no goal as he was crashing into Jared Hines. And so we're going to face off to the left of Jared Hines. Brett, did you catch who scored that?
No, I did not. There was so much noise going on in the background. I did not catch who scored that one.
As Wainman fixes his equipment after that partial breakaway. Shots are now 19-18 in favor of the Lynx. They're out shooting Boston 10-4 in this period. Into the corner, this is Janky. A shot saved by Hines off the stick of Edwards. Around the boards it goes. That puck bounces high in the air and sent back down into the half boards in the corner. Taken up with this now is Gates. Gates has the puck knocked off his stick by Bowerman, whose second effort sends it deep. Walking in with this is Janky. He holds. He tries to send it across. It deflects, and it goes just wide. Bounced off a friendly stick for Jared Hines. And Nick Lupo will start up. Lupo chips it off the boards. Too far for Gates. First one there is Bowerman. He's got Gates all over him. Gates gets the puck back, and Bowerman tries to steal it away from him. It's on the stick of Lupo now. Lupo in the corner. Tries to walk out with it as the puck knocked off his stick and takes a whack from Edwards. Gates has the puck jump past him, and Stalkowski tries to send it up. Goes on to the stick of Edwards. He passes ahead. That was Varner trying to send a cross ice pass, and does. Jakobin's shot carries wide. Skating away with this is Stalkowski.
I'm sorry, Andrew. Belleville comes at you from different angles all over the place here.
You know, deadly team, and they fire on will. Skating in with this now is Schroeder. He shoots, and a save by Miller, and he'll hang on. 7:42 to go in the second period. It's a 5-1 lead for the Lynx.
Now, Lindenwood coming out from different angles. That time, you know, just a moment ago, a flip into the zone. Player skates on the back end, or on the backboard, just comes down, gets that shot, and pretty much that's what Lindenwood seems to do. Just all different angles, all different avenues to get to the net.
That shot goes wide right off the faceoff. Boston trying desperately to get back into this game. And here comes Lindenwood again. Long stretch pass onto the stick of Varner. Has the puck knocked away. Keeps it in his feet. Harassed the whole way by Sutterman. And a nice move there by Wengmo, who has the fourth goal. Around the net it goes. Hussey takes his man down. No call on the play and takes a check for his efforts. And anyway, this is Krusenberry. Krusenberry fans on the clearing attempt, and Trubisch was there, but only for a moment. Krusenberry sends ahead to the stick of Hussey. Offsides!
And there's an audible groan from the Lindenwood Belleville bench because they thought they had another opportunity to move in for more.
You figure one more goal has got to be a backbreaker. It's already a tough task for the Terriers down four.
It's already a tough task when you consider, you know, Lindenwood scores almost low, sometimes it seems like.
Down the right wing, this is Sutterman in the corner. Throws it in front, goes through the crease. Picked up by Matos, he holds. Tries to send it out, is knocked off by Tyson. Chipped up and kept in at the line by Messick. He sends hard around. First one there is Crawford for Belleville. He sends up the boards. It's taken by Pagliacci. Pagliacci makes a nice move. Sends a pass under the stick of Bruno. Brady Bruno drops it back and gets a pass back from Tanner Duffney. Bruno out in front. Gets it back. Sends it hard around and Duffney there. Duffney has Tyson in the slot. He shoots. Good save by Hines. And he gives a little stick into the feet of Landon Hybert, as if to say good job, and Hybert, or excuse me, that wasn't Hybert, that was Pagliacci, taps him back and says, hey, good job yourself.
It's the one thing with Lindenwood, and last year's Lindenwood team was even better, some think, than this year's one. Except Belleville's only given up 67 goals in 28 games. You can just imagine the tall task ahead.
You almost wonder what would happen if they would have been eligible last year out in Utah.
Yeah.
That would have been a fun tournament to see. Anyway, over here and now, it's a 5-1 lead for the Lynx with 6 minutes and change to go in the second period. And this is Pagliacci trying to send back low for Tyson. Christian Tyson. harassed the whole way by Balbo. Goes down, Balbo takes the puck, and it's kept in only momentarily and sent back in offsides by Bishop. 3-on-1 now for the Terriers, walking in with this is Esposito as the puck is knocked off his stick by Bowerman. Bowerman and Esposito collide in the corner. Bruce out in front, and Miller will calmly put a glove on it, and so he gets a stick for his trouble, and now we get a pile up in the corner. There was an extra stick thrown in there by Esposito, and Bowerman went in hard after him. His eyes were on fire.
Well, we're probably going to get some matching minors coming out of this, I would imagine. Or maybe the extra on Boston for the stick work.
Referees will sort everything out. Feinberg being escorted to the box, as is Kyle Bishop. And we'll play 4-on-4 as Feinberg gets a slashing call and Bishop gets a roughing call. So coincidentals, but they both go up on the board and
play 4-on-4. How many penalties have been called in this game, which Belleville does like to play a free-flow style, you know, likes to get the tempo of the game going, and they like to have games with good pace to them. So it's not totally surprising that we're in a game that has got a few, five penalties overall?
Five penalties now with those two coincidentals. Three before that. Brendan with Belleville 1-for-2 on the man advantage. Boston 1-0-for-1. They should score! Landon Hybert locked down the slot, and he beats Hines over the stick side. 6-1, Lyndon with Belleville.
And they can shoot the puck, just Belleville squad. Sometimes it just looks like an innocent play coming in, and like, that's going to do it for Hines. And they're going to switch goalies, Boston University. Ryan Mack is going to check into the game now, but that's what they do. They can skate up down, find those open lanes, and shoot. And now Ryan Mack on the season 5-2 with 3.01 goals against average and an .856 save percentage checks in.
So Jared Hines plays 34 minutes and 34 seconds and gives up 6 goals on 21 shots.
Definitely won't help the stat line, but that's how good Lindenwood can shoot the perimeter of Belleville. That's how good they can shoot the puck. They're a very accurate team.
Strzalkowski takes over and loses the puck in the corner to Hussey as we get a collision in the slot, and down it is hard with Hines. Oh, and Hines is hurt. Michael Gates, excuse me. Michael Gates is hurt. He went down hard and is
behind the play. I think there was a little tangle up and he got a stick where it's never a comfortable situation, so
he's writhing in pain. He's very much in pain. And our trainer's looking at him. Just an innocent collision, like you said, Brett. They just kind of got tangled up there. And he's able to stand up. He's being helped off the ice, not able to put any weight on that right foot. And you just hope it's a sting or a cramp or something like that, yeah, so you can see him come back. Yeah,
I don't know if he got a stick to the leg or something, or when he was tangled up behind the play, something might have wrenched out, and he'll head to the back to get looked at.
And I think they're going to probably just take him out to the dressing room, as the dressing rooms are located just behind the benches here. And so we're going to face off to the right of Ryan Mack. That one is taken now by Tamer Hanning. Sent the length of the ice, and this will be an icing. As we get some confusion here.
Because what's happening is what was happening is what Lindenwood's saying, what everybody's saying is that the icing was initiated, then waved off, and that's why the goaltender, goaltender Miller came out to play it. And he's like, yeah, I see your guy wave it off, and so now everybody's just going to bring out the center ice and let's get it off.
Face-off at center ice with 4.5 minutes to go in the second period and a 6-1 lead for the Lindenwood Belleville Lynx. 52 seconds to go on the matching minors to Bishop and Feinberg. This is Wayman sending a long home run pass into the glove of McLupo. All the way down it goes. Krusenberry takes it over for Lindenwood Belleville. Wayman can't get it out as Balbo keeps it in. Hits off the back of Wayman and it goes into the feet of Edwards. Edwards sends a long cross-ice pass. First one there, Timur Hannon. Pinching in was Wayman, but the puck is stolen away by Lupo. Lupo's got a lane, and he takes it with 4 minutes to go. Lupo has the puck knocked away, and it's a breakaway here. This is Edwards walking in. He shoots, and he missed the net.
Well, they go after corners like crazy, Delta. Such an accurate team, such a heavy shooting team.
As we have an offsides call, Lupo dished it off to Faso, but then went for a change and didn't realize that he had to stay on sides there. So it's 3 seconds to go in the matching minors to Bishop and Feinberg, 3:43 to go in the second period. It's a 6-1 lead for the Lindenwood Belleville Lynx. Andrew Shapiro alongside Brett Luthner, day one of Pool D action between the Boston University Terriers and the Lindenwood Belleville Lynx here at the 2016 ACHA Division II National Championships as Kyle Miller makes that save. We're back to 5-on-5. Long outlet pass goes on goal and Mack will have to freeze it as he had a Lynx player, Pagliacci, coming down on him.
Yeah, it was a smart thing. That's one of those, we're going to dump it in, we're going to see if the goalie plays it. He ends up covering up and now face off to the left.
That's one of those win-win plays for Belleville. If they get a whistle, they get an offensive zone face-off. If the goalie plays it, you get a chance to get some offensive pressure. Puck is taken by Hybert, sends it around the boards. O'Leary checked by Philly, but gets the puck back. Loses it in his feet. Hybert has it now. Looks out in front for Philly. But it's stolen away by the co-captain of the Terriers, Dylan Schuler. He sends for Trubisch. Trubisch is saved. The puck bounces up, and Miller has to bounce on his shot. Score! Boston never gave up on it. And it looks like that's going to be Dan Sutterman getting the goal. And Boston is back to within four. It's 6-2 with exactly 3 minutes to go.
Now I think Miller lost track of that initial shot. It went behind him. And you can see him with looking around, he knew he didn't get all of it. He knew the puck went somewhere. And so he started to fish behind him to see where it was. And in the ensuing scramble, BU managed to put one up.
Dan Sutterman's third goal of the season. That's a big one. It keeps this game relatively close. And Boston has the puck again now, trying to gain some momentum off of that goal. Spinning with this is Crawford. He sends a long outlet pass. Glove down by Woods. Woods over the center line. Gains into the Boston zone and it's turned over. Away with this is Pagliacci. Pagliacci down the left wing. Takes it behind the net but has the puck knocked off his stick and cleared all the way around by Esposito. Kept in at the line by Jacopin. Puck sits in the slot and cleared out by Boston. Feinberg along the pass for Parkinson. All the way down. Jacopin the first one there for Belleville. He sends it across for Van Ness. Van Ness in the Zamboni corner. Across for Jacopin. Up the boards kept in by Hannon. Behind the net it goes. Esposito has the puck knocked away by Van Ness. Kept it at the line by Balbo. He sends it hard around. First one there, Esposito for Boston. Into the feet of Van Ness and sent around. Kept in by Hannon at the point. Hannon holds. Fires a shot. Goes wide. Looks like it deflected off a Lindenwood player there. And they go one-on-one and away with it. Skate the Lynx. Glove down by Hannon. He sends it across and it's intercepted now by Jacopin. Jacopin down the right wing. 3-on-2. He holds. He dishes it off into the feet of Bassard. Intercepted now by Trubisch. Trubisch chips it off the wall for Lupo. He takes the spill. Lupo, see the end. The puck is whistled down for an icing with 1:34 to go in the second period.
It's, you know, with the 6-2 game in favor of Belleville, it's one of those games like, yeah, they're telling the better team right now, the highest seeded team, but it's got that feel of, you know, Boston still, if things went certain ways, would still be in this game.
There's a save by Mack off the faceoff. And Lupo takes over for the Terriers. across the ice it goes. Nifty move there by Faso. He starts up 3-on-2. Faso shoots, catches the high glass, gets his own rebound and tries to throw it across. It's intercepted. Federer skates Belleville. Weber sends too far off the stick of Varner. Varner into the corner. He spins off a check from Lupo. Goes down. Nothing called. Weber has it. Fishes out. To the point it goes. This is Langmo across for Krusenberry. Trubisch the first one there. He spins off. To the point it goes. Kept in by Krusenberry. His shot caromed off the boards. I think that was a carefully placed pass. But no matter, as it's intercepted by Schalkowski with 48 seconds to go in the second period. This pass goes onto the stick of Nick Lupo. Lupo dishes back. Shot saved by Miller, and he will cover up with 39.8 seconds remaining in the second period.
Andrew, this is another one of those good little counter there by Boston after the pressure in the zone. And so now, here's what you want. Try to win this draw. Get it into a shooting avenue for a quick shot. Build off something, and of course they're going to lose the draw.
Face off behind the net, taken by Van Ness. Off the glass and all the way down it goes. First one there, Brad Edwards. He loses it to Scott Woods. Woods up the wall. Tyson keeps it. He takes a check and sends it into the Boston zone. Janky tried to get there for Linden with Belleville. He's knocked over. This is Edwards behind the net, out in front. Edwards tries to dish it out in front for Janky, but nothing doing. With 10 seconds to go in the period. Get a little tongue-tied there, all this action. Tyson has it at the point with 5. He winds, fires, it's blocked into the feet of Milo Moroder. And that pass, as Moroder gets taken down as the buzzer expires. So at the end of the second period, it's a 6-2 lead for the Lindenwood Belleville Lynx. They outshoot Boston 13-7 in the second period and tack on 4 goals to add to their lead. And Brett Luthner will be standing by with our second period interview. Just waiting on head coach Lindsay Middlebrook. And as Brett is joined by Lindsay Middlebrook, we take you ice level for our second period interview.
Hi, coach. 6-2 after 2. Your thoughts on how your team's played through the first 40?
We've been okay. We were a little rusty. We played games, so I see each period. The first was okay. Second was better. Hopefully we start to click a little bit more in the third, but it's been a good one.
First go-around national championships for this team, how have they responded to it?
Good. You know, they're a pretty laid-back group of guys, but they showed some a little more exuberance than I thought they might. So as long as they curtail and keep it in a positive way, they're good.
Yep, thanks, sir. Good luck.
Thank you, bud.
Yep, we're back up to you, Andrew.
Thank you, Brett. That was Lindsay Middlebrook with our second period interview. And at the end of 2 periods of play here in Westchester, it's a 6-2 lead for the Lindenwood Belleville Lynx. You're watching the ACHA Division II National Championships on YouTube. Welcome back to Westchester, Pennsylvania for the ACHA Division II National Championship Tournament. I'm Andrew Shapiro alongside Brett Leithner, and we're very happy to be bringing you Day 1 of Pool D action. Right now, we've got the Lindenwood Belleville Lynx taking the ice on one end and the Boston University Terriers at the other. It's a 6-2 lead for Belleville after the second period. They seem to be enjoying the atmosphere created for them, don't they, Brett?
Help if I turned it on.
There we go. Technical difficulties aside, you were saying.
It would help if I turned my mic on. Belleville coming out to some Meliot in the background there, and decided to sing along with it before they hopped out on the ice right after the chorus. By the way, just giving some other scores. Arizona State in the 6-4 lead on Michigan State as they head to the third. And there's a couple others that we'll get to in a little bit.
That's a burn burner there. So as we get ready to bring you third period action, it'll be the Lynx moving left to right on your camera with your white jerseys trimmed in black, and the Boston University Terriers moving right to left in the red trimmed with white. A lot of scoring to go over, so we'll do that as the game goes on. And right now we've got Belleville sending the puck in deep. Behind there it goes. Other scores to report. Penn State trailing NYU 6-1 after the second period. That's in Pool A. And in Pool C action, we've got Liberty leading Arizona State Maroon. Excuse me, Pool B. Liberty leading Arizona State Maroon, 3-1. So here and now we have action as the puck is up in center ice and Faso will send across.
You gave the rest of the scores then.
Yes, I did. Is that pass? Goes up over to the glass, and there's a souvenir for a lucky fan off the stick of Dylan Schuller with 43 seconds gone by.
And what it's setting up for, as we get all the scores early on, is right now it's looking like the chalk across the board is going to be taking action here on day one, which doesn't happen. It hasn't happened in quite some time.
Absolutely. Usually you see a couple upsets here and there. Now, of course, there's still plenty of hockey left to be played on all four rinks.
Yeah.
But as of right now, it's looking like the ones and the twos will be coming away with victories.
And the closest one, I mean, you got two-goal games on each of the other two rinks. So we'll see how it goes going along here as we get all the elements lined up here and everything. There's 18:55 to go here on the third. But if these results hold up and all the one-twos hold up, tomorrow's really going to set up to be moving day in those games where the ones play the threes.
And the twos play the fours, yeah. So we got a face off to the right of Kyle Miller, who has thus far made 20 saves. Behind the net, this is Bowerman has the puck poked away and gets it back. Dylan Bowerman, and the Lynx are offside, so they'll have to regroup. And a free out for the Terriers. And the free out is taken now by Scott Woods. Down the left wing he goes. He holds a shot blocked on the way by Bowerman. Controlled by the Lynx. Kept in the line by Feinberg only briefly as it's cleared out to center ice. Rubber goes down hard off the stick of Feinberg. And Woods will start up. Walks into two Lynx and has the puck knocked away. Langmo tries to send all the way down. It goes too far for any white jerseys. And the first one out there is Ryan Mack, who came in to relieve Jared Hines, who let up six goals. Esposito down the left wing. Spins off a check along the half boards. Sends it out to the point. Hannon shot. Pad save made by Miller. Knocked down very neatly by Balbo. And it'll be sent into the Boston zone. Curling with the puck now is Matos. He sends across. This is Sutterman. Sends the puck all the way down. First one there is John Krusenberg. Along the half boards and now out of the zone. Back in very briefly, and it's offsides are the Terriers. So we're going to whistle with 2:28 gone in the third period and a 6-2 lead for the Lindenwood Belleville Lynx.
I'm just trying to get a couple of other things going on, ready to go. As you see, it looks like Belleville trying to, they want to ride this game out. They want to keep it solid. They don't want to give up any more goals. You don't want to get behind in terms of the goals allowed situation.
And it's actually 7-1 NYU after two periods of play.
Yikes. And that escalated quickly.
Yes, it did. Puck goes around the net, and Miller will play it across for his teammate, Van Ness. Off the half-boards and kept it at the line by Fosso. He sends hard around. First one there for the Lynx is Crawford. Up the boards and out of the zone off the stick of Pagliacci. Chipped up along to Fosso. Fosso, long stretch pass blocked on the way in by Jacopin. And it'll be taken by O'Lear. O'Lear has to chase down that one and sends it around for Fosso. Fosso in the corner, tries to send up, it's intercepted. Gets it back and it's cleared on a second effort all the way down. And this will carry for icing. So the faceoff will be back in the Boston University zone with 3:25 gone in a third period that sees Lindenwood Belleville with a 6-2 lead. Despite being outshot 23-22.
Again, though, Lindenwood Belleville just so good at shooting the puck. They're an excellent puck shooting team, and when you get those opportunities and shoot and can snipe like that, you know, it's when you can snipe like that, that's a tremendous asset for your team.
And it makes for a dangerous opponent no matter who you play.
Yep.
So turning up with this one is Hybert, who sends all the way down behind the net, and Mack will have to come out to play it. Mack leaves it. Goes along the half boards and it's battled for two aside. Trubisch comes in to make the advantage for BU. And the puck rolls into the corner and it goes behind there where O'Lear will take over. Ryan O'Lear starts up. Dishes off to Trubisch and takes the drive-by hit. Offsides are the Lynx and they'll recover. First one there for Boston University is Brandon Messick. Benjamin Messick, excuse me. Behind the net, this is Bowerman. He sends up the wall. Kept in at the line. Messick out in front looking for a teammate. Matos couldn't find him. 2-on-1 partially. Boy, the puck goes away. And this is Sutterman. Down to the ice hard on his own accord went Matos. Looked like he just lost an edge there. And it's picked up by Sutterman. Sutterman has the second BU goal. Tries to go for his third and is faced by Adam Jacopin, who knocks it away. Pass goes across. And we're looking at a 2-on-1 here for Belleville. Down the wing, this is Duffy across. Holding, shot, a save by Mack off the stick of Janky. And back comes BU 2-on-2 with Janky backchecking. Shot saved by Miller, and he'll hang on off the stick of Scott Woods. 15:03 to go in the third period, and it's a 6-2 lead for the Lynx.
Did you say it's a nondescript period right now?
Yeah.
We're just getting after it. Both teams going through it. It has a feel of a systems period.
this is one of those periods where you see Belleville, they're going to try to work on everything to get more in shape for the teams that they're going to have to face down the road. And BU, they're obviously trying to get back into this game, down by 4 goals, but they know that they have a tough task, and they're just trying to get back to fundamentals and see if that'll work for them, because it got them here in the first place. Yep. Long pass onto the stick of Feinberg, and he's checked hard by Crawford. Skating up with this is Janky. He sends across. This is Duffney. Leads it back for Crawford. Crawford back for Duffney, but couldn't pull the trigger, and we get a stoppage of play as the net is dislodged.
Oh, penalty call coming up, too. We have an arm up.
They're just signaling no change. They're signaling no change in the face-off inside the BU zone.
It's funny, going back to the NYU game at 7-1 now after two. You talk to some people around, and you know, it's almost like, well, it's like, you know, Penn State, they're down, but they're not out of it. It's something that they're used to doing, and all of a sudden NYU put an end to that, going up 6 goals.
Seems to be the case here, though, as a wraparound is stopped by Mac, as another shot saved by Mac. Ryan Mac's come in this game. He's been busy.
Boston's not a come-from-behind team.
No, they are not.
They're a team that needs to play out in front to establish their systems a little bit. And, you know, pretty much once they got down, in my mind, 4-1, that became a very difficult cast for them.
And Belleville's not a team that squanders a lot of leads either, so. Nope. It's a tall order for the Terriers, but stranger things have happened. Into the corner, this is Weber out in front. Weber can't pull the trigger. It goes into the corner. Long puck is gloved down by Krusenberry. Krusenberry chips it ahead for Varner. Varner walking in. He dishes off, trying to find Weber on the back door, but couldn't. As that puck goes into the Boston bench. So we're going to whistle with 13:31 to go in the third period and a 6-2 lead for the New England Belleville.
Yeah, it's what I'm seeing is it's still even at this moment, the off-the-puck precise movement by Belleville. It's like, you know, they cut to spots hard and crisp, and the passing is solid. And just, even though up 6-2, you figure they're just like, let's ride it out. They're still going through their stuff with a level of crispness.
Well, not only is no lead safe, but of course, the tiebreakers here at Nationals, you want to try to get a goal differential, even though it is one of the fourth or fifth tiebreakers that you really have to worry about. So Lindewood plays the puck behind their own net, and it's up for Jonathan Philly. Long stretch across ice pass goes under the stick of Pagliacci. He's got a partial break. Looking on the back door, but it was blocked away that by Messick. Pagliacci shot saved by Mack. The puck is loose behind the net, taken by Strzalkowski. Has it back. Up the boards, but chipping it, pinching it was Lengmo. That shot pad saved by Mack. Puck is loose. The rebound goes wide. Into the corner it goes as Woods throws a cross check, but to no call. Skating up with this is Boston. It's a 3-on-2, a 4-on-2 if Lupo can join the rush. Strzalkowski shot and a blocker save by Miller. Strzalkowski behind the net. It goes, this is Krusenberry. Krusenberry, pass intercepted by Lupo. Lupo and Krusenberry battle for it. Trubisch takes over for Boston. Tyler Trubisch. And the Terriers are offside. So it'll be a face-off just outside the LUB zone. So looking ahead to tomorrow, a couple of the games that jump out at me. Miami and Boston, that's really going to be who's going to still have something to play for on Sunday. And for BU, it's a pride thing. And for Miami, it's coming back after a tough loss today to Utah, 4-2, in what is thus far the closest game of the tournament. As that shot carries up over the net.
Yeah, well, what it does too, like you said, playing for something on day three. You know, because right now, the way it's setting up, you're going to have a situation where possibly, oh, that's a big hit.
And a penalty as the back ref makes the call. And so Boston will go back on the power play. This will be their third of the game. Or their second of the game, excuse me. So we're going to get 2 minutes for boarding on Dylan Bowerman.
Yeah, a heavy hit behind the net there going after the puck. I don't think any intent of ill will, so to speak. But unfortunately, Bowery caught him in a bad spot. So, and power play Boston only a second.
And they are 0-for-1 on the day with a couple of shots and a couple of decent chances. There's Woods firing a shot that catches the high glass wide. That shot saved by Miller, and he'll cover up off the stick of Taylor Parkinson. So this is a chance for Boston to kind of get back into this game, if not physically on the scoreboard, then at least mentally and emotionally get themselves back into this game and say, hey, we're not dead yet. Face off to the left of Miller is won by the Lynx, and it'll be sent all the way down and out of the zone by Christian Tyson. Oh, kept in. Kept in at the line. Got by Messick. And a good job by Feinberg to keep it in. Feinberg's going to keep it in. He's taken down as the puck is cleared down, and Woods will start over for the Warriors. Minute 30 to go in this power play for the Lindenwood Belleville Lynx. And it'll be taken by Esposito. Esposito down the right wing. He's got Taylor all over him. Around the wall it goes. Kept in by Woods. Woods sent down. And the puck is clear all the way down to the other end of the ice. And Maklop to come out and leave it for Benjamin Messick. 1:08 to go in the penalty to Bowerman. And a 10:57 to go in the third period. It's a 6-2 lead for the Lynx. Cross-ice pass onto the stick of Parkinson. Handles it backwards and leaves it off for Shalkowski. Shalkowski walks in. He shoots and it goes up and over the end. Shalkowski loses his stick and takes a spill. Lupo to the point of goals for Faso. Faso holding. Back to Lupo. He spins away. Lupo has it. Goes back to Faso. Faso shoots and a glove save by Miller and he'll hang on. Nice and easy save there for Kyle Miller. 38 seconds to go on the man advantage for the Terriers as they trail Lindenwood Belleville 6-2.
And again, not much in the way of pressure here. You get the long shots easily seen by Miller. Good job by Belleville. Clear out the front and keep the puck at the perimeter here on this power play.
Oh, there goes across. A shot by Faso goes wide. Intercepted by Lupo. He walks out. He shoots Penn. Saved by Miller. The puck is loose. Miller tries to pounce on it. We have a quick whistle, much to the disapproval of the BU bench to our right, as the puck was loose and looking like the net might have been off its moorings. But either way, it's a face-off to the left of Kyle Miller.
Yeah, the Boston bench not too happy that the whistle was blown there, but you know, sometimes these are the things that happen.
So it'll be tough enough to come back from 6-2 down, especially on your own, but when the refs are not exactly helping you, it's a little bit more of a challenging task. To the point it goes, and it hops over the stick of Faso, who's got a man all over him. Good pressure there by Belleville in the person of Kyle Bishop, but Faso will skate up with 5 seconds to go and the man advantage. Strakowski takes it into the corner as Zach on the ice comes Bowerman, and Miller has to jump out of his crease to smother a loose puck, and we'll get a whistle with 9:50 to go in the third period. And we will be able to take our media time out. You are watching the ACHA Division II National Championship live from Iceline in Westchester, Pennsylvania. We would like to thank Pro Stock Hockey, Bauer USA Hockey, and Barron Championship Rings, the official provider of Championship Ring Supplier for the ACHA. And of course, we'd like to thank Westchester's Visitors Bureau, Iceline Quad Rinks, App Hammer, and our broadcast partner, University of Utah Hockey. And as always, we're very glad that we can bring you this broadcast free for the second year in a row. We're glad you're able to join us. It's a 6-2 lead for the Lindenwood Belleville Lynx, as they lead the Boston University Terriers in the second game of Pool D action, day one. Earlier today in this pool, University of Utah knocked off the Miami of Ohio Redhawks 4-2. And it's been chalk across the board, as Brett would say. Here and now, though, we got a face-off won by the Terriers, and it's kept in. Sent out of the zone, and it'll be taken over by Boston. Sent back all the way down, and Crawford will be the first one there. Crawford goes across for Kruzenberg. Long stretch pass. Goes all the way down, and that'll cross the goal line for an icing. Earlier scores from today, Grand Valley State defeated Utah State 6-1. Same score was the final for William Patterson University against Lindenwood University. Florida Gulf Coast University over Keene State College 11-1. And of course, we already told you, Utah beat Miami 4-2.
Man, think that William Patterson Lindenwood game, everybody thought would be closer than that.
Absolutely. And here comes a partial break, but a good defensive play there by Balbo. As forechecking hard as Tanner Duffney. Intercepted behind the net. It goes out in front. Shut off the crossbar. Brandon Jenke rings it off the pipe. Behind the net it goes. Derek Van Ness sends across for Zach Crawford. Crawford taken down. No call on the play. The physical play really starting to heat up here. Van Ness has it for Lindenwood Belleville. He sends a stretch pass under the stick of Brad Edwards. Edwards gains the blue line and sends a cross-quarter dump in that's picked up by Jenke. And the puck hits the netting behind the glass, and we'll get a whistle with 8:49 to go in the third. But Brandon Jenke, he beat him on the glove, but couldn't beat the bar.
I might have caught not bar, but post. He couldn't beat iron no matter which way you cut it. And, you know, hey, listen, sometimes those are the breaks that go against you in these games.
Where's the shot score? Daniel Hussey bangs it home. And it's 7-2 Lynx with 8:45 to go in the third.
And just getting out in front, you know, loose puck in the slot, Boston not able to completely corral players, and this is what Lindenwood does so well, is they find, again, that open ice, they find open spaces to get to, so when the puck pops, when the puck pops free there, they're able to bang home, and that's why they can score so many goals.
Daniel Hussey, the team leader in points, scores his 26th goal of the season for point number 61 on the year. And behind the player, a couple of players get tangled up, so Trubisch can't bring the puck in. Woods has it now for Boston University. He walks in, makes a nifty move, but loses the puck as Miller tries to leave it, or tries to push it around, excuse me, for his partner, Dylan Bowerman, who has it now. Puck kept it in the feet of Woods, and Woods does a nice job of keeping it in again. Knocked out of the air by Varner, and it'll be cleared on a second effort. This is Tyler Weber, gains the red line and sends it in deep. First one there for Lindenwood is Hussey. Hussey behind the net, spins it around. Back across for Weber. Weber spins off a check and takes it into the corner himself. He's got Woods on him, sends a pass and a shot from the point. Goes wide, out in front. That shot by Varner never made it through. Up and out of the zone. Taken over by Krusenberry. Krusenberry sends a long pass. Too far for anybody in a white jersey. And Faso, the first one there for Boston, as Belleville completes a change. John Faso starts up the left wing. Nice stretch pass onto the stick of Taylor Parkinson. Faso has it now at center ice. To Feinberg. And it's sent in on goal, and Miller will have to cover up, as he's got Lucas Esposito flying through. Then we get a whistle with 7:10 to go in the third period, a face-off to the right of Miller.
At this point now, you're up 5, and it looks like you're in control of the game, just ride it out, even though you're getting outshot 30-24.
Make it 31, and shot score! Right off the faceoff, Miller made the save, and Lupo bangs home his second of the game. And it's 7-3, Lindenwood.
Keep in mind, every one of these goals is important because of the tiebreakers. You know, when it comes down to, you know, before it gets to goal, you know, head-to-head number of wins, and third one's fewest goals against. And so, right now, that's a goal that Lindenwood did not want to give up.
Absolutely. You're up by 5 already. The deficit is now cut to 4, but more importantly, it's a third goal you've allowed this tournament after not allowing really more than 2 or 3 goals a game in the regular season. And you're playing the 4 seed allowing 3 goals. You still have to play the 2 and the, you still have to play the 3 and the 2 in your pool. So it'll be taken now by the Lynx in the person of Zach Crawford, who sends up the wall. Long stretch pass intercepted by BU. O'Lear. Down low for Crawford between the circles. For Tyson. Up ahead for Philly. He sends in deep. First one there for the Terriers is Alex Balbell. 7-3 lead for the Lindenwood Belleville Lynx, and they're being outshot 31-24. That pass onto the stick of Jared Bessard. Sends it in deep. Cannon tries to send it around. It's intercepted by Hybert. Out in front, saved by Mack. Tyler Trubisch with it now. He sends a stretch pass, glove down by Tyson. Has the puck knocked away from him. And a stretch pass goes across ice to Kyle Bishop. Bishop sips it in deep and handing the first one there. Up around into the feet of Hybert. Trubisch there. The battle for a 2-on-1. And coming away with it is Boston. Strakowski tries to send around, and it does go onto the stick of Mrazek. Mrazek down the left wing, shoot, pad save, puck is loose, another pad save by Miller. Boston really turning up the pressure here, they're not going away quietly. Landon Hybert down the right wing, he sends all the way down. No icing as the first one there is Benjamin Messick. Puck stolen away by Belleville. Shot, that one ends accidentally blocked by Woods, and he kind of hit him in the head as Feinberg has passed, is intercepted. The battle for it right in front of us, and Woods will take it in. Excuse me, Messick will take it in. He wins the race and takes a check from Bowerman. Bowerman goes down and takes Messick with him. Behind there it goes, Bowerman. In the corner, trying to start out for the Lynx. All the way down, out of the zone. It's a 3-on-0 for Belleville. Bruno, shot, score! Brady Bruno picked it up, sent it across to Brandon Janky, got it back, and deposits a goal. And it's 8-3 Lindenwood, and so for Brady Bruno, that is his ninth goal of the season, and seems to be the final straw, the final nail in the coffin here.
Yeah, it's just, again, catch a few players one way, bust it out the other. 3-0 against this team, how are you going to, you know, Mac does all he can, you know, try to guess what they're going to do, and then it's tic-tac going. It'll be on to day two, and Boston's going to have to regroup and figure out what to get done here.
Right now, this is Ryan O'Lear with the puck, and quick little passing for the Terriers isn't really going to do too much for them as the puck is sent back into their end. Faso has it behind the net, has the puck stolen away from him. Well, Belleville is just relentless as we get a whistle and a penalty behind the play. The back referee making the call for interference, and it looks like it's going to go against Lindenwood Belleville as Brandon Janky is making the guilty skate to the box. So BU goes back on the power play. They are 0-2 on the day. And they'll get a power play with 4:39 to go here in the third.
And some entertaining banter between the referee and the Lindenwood bench. Some smiles going about along it.
It's a little bit easier to smile when you're up by 5 goals.
There's some truth to that, Sid.
Kept in by O'Leary. That shot by Faso is gloved down by Miller. So just over 4.5 minutes to play here in the third period. It's a 8-3 lead for the Lindenwood Belleville Lynx. They're killing off a penalty, their third of the game. That shot blocked on the way in, and it's blocked down again in the slot. Brandon Hybert has it. He's got a man, finds him. Breaking away with this now is Bishop. Bishop to the backhand, taken down. No call on the play as Strakowski takes over for BU. Bishop the first one there. He'll hold it up into the corner. Coming away with this is Strakowski. Strakowski up the right wing. Cuts back to center ice. He shoots and a save by Miller, and the puck has cleared the length of the ice. And so Mac will leave it for Benjamin Messick with 3:58 to go in the period and 1:17 to go in the man advantage. Cross ice pass under the stick of Strakowski. Strakowski spins, keeps the puck along the blue line and it's out of the zone. Woods couldn't keep it in as the puck was elevated by Strakowski, who has it now. Strakowski over the blue line, holds it in the corner, turns and he sets it up. This is Woods, firing a shot, blocked on the way, he gets it back. Woods across. Excuse me, that's Woods now with the puck. That earlier was Parkinson. Woods has the puck poked away by Bassard, and he can't keep it in, and sent the length of the ice.
Okay,
42 to go on the man advantage.
Good there. Tyler Webber, number 47, two excellent plays defensively. Keep anything from getting through the net.
Lindenwood Belleville not giving anything easy. As this is Scott Woods, his shot blocked on the way in by Zach Crawford. BU will have it. Woods fires a shot. His stick goes in half, and as we like to say, there goes $200. More like $260 at this point.
Yeah.
First one there is Bishop.
Pro shop will be open until after the game.
We'll have plenty of time to get another stick for day two.
And Woods was so angry that that stick shattered. When he threw the stick, his glove went flying as well.
Yep.
Blood sale.
And that'll do it for the Boston Pop. I think we're 0-3 on the day, as Derek Van Ness sends it all the way around, and it can't be kept in. All the way down, first one there is Janky out of the box. Janky goes behind the net. Somebody just threw their stick, or accidentally ran into it. Janky gets taken down. No call on the play, as this is Esposito.
Oh, he was trying to draw one.
That shot almost deflected off the glove and in of Ryan Mack. It was a shot taken by, from the point by Crawford. Holding this now is Van Ness. He sends down around. Interception. Turnover behind the net. And Belleville has it. That shot saved by Mack. The puck is loose and it's taken by Belleville. That shot another save by Mack off the stick of Janky. Minute 50 to go in the third period. It's an 8-3 lead for the Lynx as they're just trying to kill the rest of the clock at the puck in the Zamboni door corner. Esposito takes over now for the Terriers. Goes out as far as center ice, and Van Ness will take it over and send it back in behind the net with a minute 35 to go. This is Hennett, all the way down too far, and an icing with exactly 90 seconds to go in the third period. And it's an 8-3 lead for the Lynx. Boston out shooting them 33-27. Brett, what's the message here if you're Boston?
Well, the message is you know what? You came in, by and large, you competed. The score's not going to show it on the end. And we got an elbowing call here. Going against Lindy Wood. I do believe that is...
Daniel Hussey will go. No, not Daniel Hussey. Excuse me. He's on the bench.
Cannot tell who that was either way.
Can't tell who that is in the box. But either way, Boston will have their fourth power play of the game. And very quickly, here comes Marotta. Marotta down the right wing. He shoots, and that shot caroms all the way around. Kept in by Trubisch. Around for Marotta. That's the point for Faso. Faso holds back for Marotta. He shoots. There's a save by Miller. The puck is loose, and it's cleared by Belleville. All the way down it goes. John Faso will take over for the Terriers with a minute 5 to go in the period. 1:35 to go in the penalty to whoever it was for whatever the infraction was.
Elbowing is the problem, no doubt, offside here.
Okay, so we have an elbowing call. That's half the puzzle, and the other half the puzzle is who got the penalty, but it is of no consequence to this moment as there are 58 seconds to go in the period.
John Kusenberry, number 48.
Okay, so John Kusenberry gets 2 minutes for elbowing to go on and finish his day, and there's an interception. Trubisch shoots and a save by Miller, and he'll hold on with 48 seconds to go in the man advantage. In the period, excuse me. There's a minute 18 to go in the man advantage. So it'll be a face-off to the right of Kyle Miller. Won by the Lynx and sent the length of the ice by Crawford. Clears the goal line, and the first one there will be Brad Edwards. He shoots, he scores! Brad Edwards didn't give up on the play and scores a shorthanded goal with 36.6 to go.
Yeah, and again, Littlewood's not going to, listen, you know, one of those tiebreakers, Colt, is goal differential. Littlewood's not going to stop on that, especially having given up the goal. Have to, you know, just increase.
So Edwards adds a goal to his assist tallies, and he now has 26 on the season. Actually, that's Daniel Hussey. Edwards has 27 on the season. 22 seconds to go as that shot goes wide behind the net, taken by Van Ness, and sent up but not out, and it caroms out of the zone with 14 to go. One more rush for BU as it's sent the length of the ice. This is O'Lear spinning over his blue line with 8 to go. O'Lear onto the stick of Feinberg. Feinberg gains the Lindenwood zone, a pass goes to Parkinson, 2 seconds and one, and that'll do it. And so the final score here from Rink 3, it's the Lindenwood Belleville Lynx 9, and the Boston University Terriers 3. Final shots on goal are 34-28 in favor of Boston. And They outshoot the Lynx in the period by a 13-6 total. And so Brett Luthner will be going ice level to get our player of the game. These two teams will part their ways and regroup for tomorrow. Lindenwood Belleville will be taking on the number 3 Miami University Redhawks. And Boston University will be facing off against the number 2 Utah Utes. And it looks like Brett has found our player of the game, and so we take you ice level where Brett Luthner is joined by William Varner. It will be soon, I guess, if Varner can get his helmet off. Or maybe not Varner, maybe they're getting somebody else. All right, and so it does look like Brett Luthner has our player of the game, and so we take you ice level where Brett Luthner is joined by Dwayne Wainman.
Down here with Dwayne Wayman, big win for you guys, 9-3. Talk about your thoughts the first game here.
Well, we started out a little slow. It took a while to get the left. I think play started working out, and we started winning battles on the boards, which made it work it to the middle of the ice, and eventually we got our chances and put them in the net.
First time here at Nationals. How's it feel going out there?
Oh, a lot of nerves, that's for sure. First time I've had butterflies in a while. So, I mean, at 22 years old, that was quite a feeling.
Now, you look ahead tomorrow, another big game for you. What's the focus going into tomorrow's game?
I think it's both. Trying to get prepared tonight. Starts now, getting a good meal in, hydration, and a good night's sleep, and then back out again tomorrow. I mean, hopefully we're playing 5 games in 5 days, so just on to the next one. Focus on the first period of the next game.
All right, thanks a lot. Good luck.
Take care.
Back up to you, Andrew.
All right, thank you, Brett. So, that will do it. The final score from the Iceline Quad Rinks in Westchester, Pennsylvania. The Lindenwood Belleville Lynx 9, and the Boston University Terriers 3. For Brett Luthner, I'm Andrew Shapiro saying thanks for watching and good night from Westchester.
What time is the next one?
We're done.
Oh, there's no more. Okay. Thought it was 3. Nope. There you go.
How are you doing?
Doing well. How are you? You guys still the broadcast?
Yep.
You closed the broadcast?
No, we didn't. Okay.